does a dream bring back all the memories of everything we've been through? Toast to the ones here today, toast to the ones that we lost on the way, 'cause the drinks bring back all the memories, and the memories bring back your.
I still remember my first day at the university like it was yesterday. I remember getting out of the hostel while it was so dark and so cold outside, then getting lost in the metro, trying to find the metro station which the class was located at, and then getting lost again, trying to find the building.
Memories of my first day in university would be waking up early in the morning, in the cold winter morning. It was dark and we had to find our first classes. And that was difficult because we had to navigate in a new country. We had no idea what's going on, and most of us got lost looking for classes.
And my first day in the university, I was with my friends on the English rock. There was a conference and someone happened to give us some certain of guidebooks. We gladly accepted them. And we each placed the book on a shelf in our living room. The three of us decided to cherish and keep the book forever. I stood in this place exactly and said to myself, 6 years are too long. How it will pass and finish? And surprisingly, it passed very quickly. I take this book with me everywhere now. All the flats I moved to, even in Bahrain now in COVID-19. It's a symbol of the pride I have for student of university.
What are your memories of first day in the university? Chaotic. Basically, all I can remember was chaos. It started with the orientation, and then we had our first class, and that was really strange. And then we had to sort out our documents, our groups and everything. We didn't know much. I didn't understand Russian. We didn't have a lot of information, so it was really chaotic. But all in all, it went well.
Unforgettable memories for me is when I participate in an anatomy exhibition and I got a diploma, and I participate in the university events. It's like special days, I like these days, university events. Also the New Year celebration, it's special in Moscow.
I will also never forget the time we decided to go skating in Gorky Park, but unfortunately there was a snowstorm in there and it was very windy. We fell a lot and we left a lot. It became a very funny memory today. The amazing feeling when you study hard and pass a subject with full mark, and then you reward yourself by having relaxing sleep at home. It's a feeling I will not forget easily.
So I'm known back at the day as the guy who boils eggs. Alright, so it's normal, everyone boils eggs, but when I used to come from the university back to the hostel, so I used to boil few eggs, maybe 3 to 4 eggs, and then go lay down at my bed, wait for them to finish boiling. It will take maybe 10 minutes, maybe 12 minutes. But the thing is, because my body is really tired, so I happen to fall asleep. And what happens is that the water starts finishing, yeah? So the eggs are just dancing in the pot now. So it's no longer a boiled egg anymore. It's just some grilled eggs. And for some reason, that weird reaction happens and the eggs start exploding, yeah? Now don't ask me how, just try it yourself, all right? So the eggs start exploding and just splattering all around the kitchen, back at the hostel, it's not even my apartment. So now we'll find one egg at the roof, one egg on the sides, one egg on the floor, and then it's just splattering. The yolk is everywhere, the whites are everywhere. And it's really loud, actually, the explosion. So everyone is like really shocked. And everyone like goes to the kitchen, and what's going on? What really happened? Oh, it's Isa again. So because this happened like maybe 2 to 3 times, I don't know. So everyone starts freaking out. The girls, the guys who were smoking, and they were like, oh, they get scared for real. Because it starts smelling like something is burnt, yeah? So they get started, oh, we're gonna get busted for a few eggs, yeah?
I will miss the weather the most because we don't have four seasons in Malaysia. And then I will miss the public transportations because theirs are very efficient, very systematic, meaning I don't have to worry if I miss the train that I'm currently chasing because the next train will arrive in another 30 seconds to 1 minute. And then I will miss running with my groupmates because we were late for class, running in the midst of winter with the cold winds slapping our faces. Definitely one hell of an experience.
What I'll miss the most about Moscow is the freedom to be me, the freedom to walk around freely, the freedom to go and see so many beautiful places. Oh wow. And the discounts with the social card. Yep, that too. Yeah. You know, all the places I visited with my friends. I'll miss that. And the water parks. And the transport was so cheap. And the transport system is what I will miss. The memory that what I'll miss the most is the transport system. Actually, as meh as it may sound maybe, but it is, cause it's fast. You go from place to place underground without any hassle. I don't know how else to describe it in words, but that's that. The transport system. We take advantage of it. We really do. But yeah. Especially the fact that you avoid traffic when you take the metro.
The most things like I'm gonna miss is my classmate, my friends. I have friends from different countries. And of course I'm gonna miss Christmas atmosphere and every New Year celebration with them. I'm gonna miss the snow, so we don't have here snow. No snow in Bahrain.
What I'll miss most about Moscow, I'll miss definitely the weather, the snow. I'll miss my friends, who I'm never going to see again, I think, because I have a lot of foreigner friends. I'll miss my times in class. I'll miss the relaxed days, because now, from now on, that is, it's gonna get more tense and tense and tense going into further into the career. What else? I'll miss my apartment days. I'll miss the vibes and the festivals in Moscow and the conventions. I'll definitely miss those. So yeah, I think that's pretty much all. It's a very short question. Yeah, these are the things I'm gonna miss most.
The professor who inspired me the most was Arina Azimuske, who taught me pediatrics. She was very kind, very friendly. She taught us with great lectures and accents. She makes her students comfortable and excited for the next class. She made us interested in the subject, which made us go home and simply study more about it. The next day, we would have a productive discussion with her about what we studied. So, Professor Arina, thank you. Thank you. Thank you.
And the professor that inspired me would be Professor Pisarev. He is just amazing. He's taught me a lot, not only about medicine, but about life in general.
Some professors played such a pivotal role in my, during the course of my medical school journey. The two I'm fond of the most were Tatiana Poronikina from second year histology and Butnik from third year pathophysiology. Their work ethic was on point. The most organized departments ever. So, or teachers, if I have to say it, the most organized teachers for me were Butnik and Poronikina. And they They were just amazing, their teaching styles. It's like they taught me personally because I could understand them that well. Yeah.
First of all, I would like to thank my parents for all the sacrifices they have made, for the support they have given financially, emotionally, morally, the guidance they gave when I needed it the most. And I would like to thank my close friends too for supporting me every step of the way during my journey through heartaches, anxieties, sadness. Also friends in need and the friends who left me during my darkest time, and also the professors. I would like to thank everyone for molding me into the person who I become today.
I think I will miss my friends the most, my friends who became my family over the past 6 years. I would like to thank my parents and my grandparents and my brother and my friends who supported me and had my back. Thank you.
First of all, I would love to thank God. God was there, He has been there, and He's always there. Then I would like to thank my parents. They've been wonderful too. And my group members, like I said. Yeah. And every other person, every teacher, everyone.
I'm very thankful for those who supported me, my family, my parents, my husband who was always beside me. My friends in Moscow, thank you guys for being with me. Also, my professors who teach me, thank you.
And I would like to thank, first and foremost, my parents for giving me the opportunity to come here because it was only possible through them. And then I would like to thank the rest of my family for always supporting me and pushing me and motivating me. And then, of course, my friends as well for being in this with me and making it easier.
I would love to thank my parents, or actually my whole family, for supporting me, believing in me, understanding on my side.
The people I would like to thank for supporting me throughout this journey are my parents, of course. My parents. But each and everyone who ever said to me, you can do this, Jay, you got this, just try, just go on and do it, oh, good luck. Each and everyone who's ever said to me, good luck, you can do this, I thank you. Because it went a long way, really, it did.
The number one people that must be thanked are our parents. I mean, they provided for us, they gave us the opportunity to study abroad. So all the thanks to them, and may God bless them all. The second people we owe the thanks are our good friends. I mean, they stood by us, they came to class with us, they laughed with us, they shared some really good memories with us. So thank you for the good memories, and thank you for the great and beautiful moments that we spent together. My African friends and the rest of my friends and my brothers, thank you a lot. The third people we are owed to thank are our good professors, like Professor Pisarev and Professor Alexander. They taught us really good. They inspired us really good. They taught with a real heart, and they were worried about our future. So thank you a lot, and thanks for all your lessons. And that's all. Thank you, thank you, thank you.
You've earned your breakfast so far, things are going great. I'll be there for you. When the rain starts to pour, I'll be there for you.
Like I've been there before.
I'll